He's vicious, unrelenting, the pride of Mexico. At 22, the undefeated WBC champion has had a meteoric rise.
Es un orgullo para mí representar ese día a mi país, el Día de la Independencia, toda la gente mexicana, todo México.
Tonight, with an entire nation behind him, his destiny seems preordained. But in boxing, everything can change in a single punch. Josesito Lopez wasn't supposed to be here.
Lopez stepping up. Oh, they stopped it.
Oh my God, I broke him, man.
Lopez pulls up the upset of the year.
He embodies the essence of boxing. In the ring, anything can happen.
I'm a fan of Canelo, but I still want to go in there and kick his ass. People think he's invincible and he's not.
Tonight, will the superstar's ascent continue? Or will the underdog write another storybook ending? It's Canelo Alvarez versus Josesito Lopez. And nothing is preordained.
All right, fans, here we go. It's time for the bout you've all been waiting for.
This crowd going
Las Vegas on a beautiful September Saturday, where it is also Mexican Independence Day weekend, which has become a huge boxing weekend here in the center of the boxing world. The MGM Grand has been the home to boxing's biggest stars and biggest bouts, and tonight, a new era beckons. Mexican phenom Saúl Canelo Alvarez, only 22 years old, but unbeaten in 41 bouts. And some see him becoming the sport's leading star over the next decade. Can he continue his meteoric rise? The next test is tonight, here on Showtime Championship Boxing. We take you inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Tonight's theme, Knockout Kings, with a bonus given to the best knockout of the night. In the main event, Canelo Alvarez will defend his WBC belt at 154 pounds. He'll face Josesito Lopez, the man who shocked the boxing world only 3 months ago by knocking out Victor Ortiz and earning his way into tonight's main event. But there is action throughout the night, and Mexico is well represented in each fight. In our co-feature, WBC featherweight champion Johnny Gonzalez defends his title against Mexican countryman Daniel Ponce de Leon. One of the most entertaining fighters of the last few years is back tonight, Marcos Maidana facing the experienced Jesus Soto Caras in a WBA title eliminator. And leading off, it's the first title defense of IBF bantamweight champion Leo Santa Cruz. Santa Cruz won the title in June right here on Showtime, and tonight he'll face a former world champion who had a 3-year reign at flyweight, the now 36-year-old Eric Morrell. And hi, everybody. Good evening. I'm Brian Kenny, and welcome to Showtime Championship Boxing. When Josesito Lopez stepped into the ring against Victor Ortiz 3 months ago, Ortiz Canelo Alvarez had already been announced. Lopez was a last-minute opponent, and everybody looked right past him. Boxing is mapped out kind of like a movie, with stars and bit players. But as it often happens in this sport, the opponent, in this case Lopez, didn't get the script. He broke Ortiz's jaw that night and earned his way into this event. Tonight, he gets another chance to rewrite the movie. But tonight, he will face someone who has proven himself to be a much sturdier leading man. Right now, I'd like to bring in our broadcast team for the night. Mauro Ranallo, Hall of Fame inductee Al Bernstein, and the pride of Brooklyn, USA, welterweight titleist Paulie Malignaggi. Great to be here with all of you guys.
Happy to be here with you, Ryan.
Al, let me start with you. 22 years old, very young, already very accomplished. What do you see as possible for Canelo Alvarez as he steps up into superstardom?
He's a unique combination of accomplishment and potential. You know, as you mentioned, 22 years of age, already a pro for over 6 years. He's fought 259 rounds of boxing already. And yet everyone agrees he's still a work in progress. He's going to get better as a fighter. So you can look at it a couple different ways, but one way to look at it is lots of blue sky for Canelo Alvarez.
And Paulie, you look at it, Canelo has fought Hatton. He's fought Cotto, but Matthew Hatton, Jose Cotto, the brothers of the superstars, right? And he's fought a lot of guys who are a little past their prime, but he's still only 22. Let's be fair. What do you see as the level of progression? Where is he right now?
Well, I think he's doing just fine. I mean, you're right. He's only fought the brothers of superstars and not superstars. He's fought champions and contenders, but champions and contenders who are past their prime, like Sugar Shane Mosley and Carlos Baldemir. You got to understand, he's being groomed. This is par for the course for a young phenom being groomed for superstardom. So there's not much criticism there. At just 22 years old, he's barely lost a round. You know, he's doing everything that's asked of him, which is win these fights. The big fights will come. This is just a matter of progression.
Josesito Lopez beat Tom Morrow. I said that was my Rocky moment where he beat Victor Ortiz, and it felt like that. Will we see Rocky 2, which, by the way, was one of my favorite Rockies? Yes. Can we see that again?
Well, most boxing pundits believe that Lopez's chances tonight are slim and none, and slim didn't make it to Sin City. However, one cannot discount the size of Lopez's heart, and he believes he is really going to be the first to truly test Canelo by taking the fight to him. He certainly possesses the will, but the champion's size and skill could rob the upset-minded Josesito of his, quote, Adrian, unquote, moment.
And we'll see, Al, maybe in a post-Mayweather Pacquiao world, if this is the guy to lead through the next decade. It's very possible. Guys, thank you so much. We'll let you get ready in broadcast position. Meantime, tonight, you should know, you have to be aware, an added feature here tonight. Athletes, like all humans, react to incentives. And tonight, an added incentive from the promoters of tonight's card. And you, the fan, will be a big part of this. In fact, you will decide who gets paid. If we have two or more knockouts tonight, the fans at home, you fans, and here in the arena, by the way, will vote via text messaging after the main event, and choose the best knockout of the night. The winner of the voting will be crowned Knockout King and be awarded $100,000 on top of his purse, an extra 100 grand. If there's only one knockout, then that fighter will get the $100,000 bonus. Showtime Sports is a leader in integrating social media with our viewers. Here is another way to interact with tonight's telecast.
Showtime Sports brings you the biggest fights. Now get in the game with Showtime Split Decision. Go to sd.sho.com on your iPhone or Android to get started. First, predict the outcome of the fight, then score each round live. Post your predictions to Facebook and follow the conversation on Twitter. Play the game tonight. Undefeated WBC light middleweight champion Canelo Alvarez battles upset-minded Josesito Lopez. Sign up and get ready to score.
Come, of course, our main event tonight, Saúl Canelo Alvarez versus Josesito Lopez. Now, often a star fighter can be categorized as a Hulk or heartthrob. A Hulk inspires fear and awe. Tyson, Hagler. A heartthrob keeps his looks intact and fights with style. De La Hoya, Sugar Ray Leonard. Canelo Alvarez is, for now, both. He has the looks and demeanor that brings him a sizable fan base among female fans. But he also has the methodical punishing style that wins respect from nearly all fans within his culture. To fully understand how he has become who he is, you need to see where he comes from.
Celebremos este día aventuroso, tus amigos, parientes y yo.
Que le sople.
22. 22. 22. 22, 22. 22.
En inglés.
1, 2, 3. Chepo fue el que me
puso
el apodo del Canelo.
Bravo, bravo.
Es por el pelo, por su pelo, sus rasgos, su color canela. La idea fue mía porque donde él vivía en El Salto y en la escuela, me comenta que le decían un nombre muy despectivo el que le pusieron.
Me decían pecoso, enchilado. Ahorita me da risa, ¿no? Pero cuando estaba chico, pues sí me enojaba y por eso me peleaba mucho. Yo nací en Guadalajara. Desde el kinder siempre me peleaba con compañeros. Le mandaban a hablar a mi mamá porque era muy peleonero.
De muy niño me gustaba hacerlo renegar mucho.
porque era muy corajudo y chillón. Y aquí nacieron todas las ilusiones.
Desde que vi a mi hermano más grande debutar a profesional, de ahí me nació el gusto por el boxeo.
Cuando empecé, ya veía los guantes y se los llevaba escondidas en mi casa. Ya lo traía en la sangre. Aquí en Guadalajara pronto hizo fama, ¿no? Porque era un muchachito de 15 años.
Todavía ni me la creo, la verdad. Todavía ni me la creo. Todo pasó muy rápido.
Canelo apenas tiene 22 años de vida, que a los 20 años ya era campeón mundial. Hoy yo creo que es la figura más importante del boxeo mexicano.
¡Canelito!
Yo creo que él puede hacer cosas mucho, muy importantes y llegar a ser de los grandes, de los inmortales del boxeo mundial.
Cuando hablen de boxeo, se acuerden del Canelo y que la palabra Canelo se escriba con letras grandes. Ese es mi sueño. Yo creo que nací para esto, para pelear.
Well, Canelo Alvarez turned pro at the age of 15. He was not coddled in his first few years as a pro. He now has wins over Alfonso Gomez, Kermit Cintron, and admittedly a 40-year-old version of Sugar Shane Mosley. But he's only 22, looking for big fights. He needs to win tonight to keep his belt and to keep himself at the top of the boxing food chain. Now here's another reminder that our card has the monetary incentive for all of tonight's fighters. The fans at home and here in the arena will vote via text messaging after the main event and choose the best knockout of the night. Now that's assured now that we have two knockouts, Leo Santa Cruz or Marcos Maidana. It could be those two, and we still have two more fights to go. We could have two more in there for you to text, and we will have someone on this fight card win an extra $100,000, and you will make that decision. Let's go back to Mauro Ranallo, ringside. He has shown himself to be up to the task most of all the time. And keep in mind, when he did lose a fight to Jesse Vargas, a very close fight in 2011, he did so at 140 pounds. In surprising Victor Ortiz, he jumped up to 147. Tonight, he jumps up yet again to 154 to take on Alvarez at super welterweight. It's another brutal test, but once again, it's the chance of a lifetime. Another reminder. Tonight's card has the added monetary incentive, and someone will win $100,000 on top of their purse, and you will make the call. The fans at home and the fans here at the arena will vote after the main event via text messaging and choose the best knockout of the night. As of now, Leo Santa Cruz is involved, Marcos Maidana is involved and eligible. The winner of the voting will be crowned the knockout king and be awarded the extra $100,000 for the fighter to win the bonus from Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy, the promoters of this bout. Hey, great action all night. It was an early arriving crowd, the knowledgeable fans. They knew this was a deep card. They have not been disappointed. And the main event is coming up. Canelo Alvarez, 22 years old, 40-0-1, making the fifth defense of the WBC super welterweight title, taking on the worthy challenger in Josesito Lopez. Back now with Mauro Ranallo, Hall of Famer Al Bernstein, and Paulie Malignaggi. Fellas, by the way, Mauro, I like your comment. The first second there wasn't a guy being carried out of the ring, They started to boo, and you said, these spoiled fans right away. It's a great crowd.
Absolutely.
Tremendous energy. You can feel it all throughout. Let's start with Canelo Alvarez and obviously what he has done here in the arena and Al, what he's doing on television. He's packed this place. Yep. He's big business. But what are the realities of where he is in the ring?
You know, it's interesting because we said earlier, he's kind of still a work in progress. He's a fighter who still has some defensive liabilities that they're working through. He is not a finished product at age 22, and yet he's already been able to captivate the boxing world. So we need to understand that he's not faced huge opposition yet, and there are some loopholes and some things that fighters can exploit.
All right, Josesito Lopez comes in, Paulie. If you were in the camp with Lopez, what would you tell him to say, hey, look, this is the way you can actually win this fight?
Well, if I was Josesito Lopez's team, I would be telling Josesito, hey, listen, this guy has not been tested against a young guy yet. All of this guy's opponents have been old, faded veterans. They were good at one time, but when he faced them, they didn't have the same amount of energy left that they did at one time in their careers. Josesito is the first guy in a long time, if not in Canelo's entire career, that will be in his prime, that will be trying to reach for the brass ring when he gets in the ring with Canelo. And when the going gets tough, we've seen Josesito Lopez does not back down.
Now, when you talk about the top of the boxing food chain, it is still, it's Floyd Mayweather just out of prison. Manny Pacquiao, who did lose his last fight, but many don't believe he did. I'm not one of them. Yeah. But that's the way it works out. And now here's a guy 22 years old. You wonder, Mauro, is this going to be the next superstar going forward after Pacquiao and Mayweather in their mid-30s walk away?
I think the answer is already evident here tonight. He's packed the house here in Las Vegas. He is a bona fide rock star, major box office attraction in Mexico. And again, just 22 years of age, and I'll echo what Al said, he's still a work in progress, but he's got the looks. He's definitely been able to captivate his native Mexican audience, and I think this future is very, very bright.
Al, what do you think the pace is early on? What do you think Canelo may look to do in this fight early on?
He wants to be patient and show the poise that we've always seen him show. He does not want Josesito to do what Paulie suggested, push the pace, make him do things he doesn't want to do. That's the irony of him. He's a 22-year-old who fights like a poised veteran.
Paulie, do you agree? What happens early for Canelo?
You know, I think Canelo's going to try to impose his own style, take his time, try to break Josesito down. I think Josesito Lopez, being the moment, is so big. I mean, let's face it. Not that long ago, he's fighting in small club fights. His game plan is always to come forward and make the fight. I think with the energy in the crowd, by the time that first bell rings, he's going to be so excited. I think he's going to come right to Canelo. You know, let's face it. He's not really a guy who's boxed before or gets on his toes. He fights anyway. He's going to feed off the energy and try to fight with Canelo. It's going to be up to Canelo to try to impose his own style.
You tell us, Paulie, as well. When you're 140 pounds, which you were, you're now 147. When you're banging with a guy 140, 147 or 154, can you feel that difference?
You can, and not just in the punching power. You feel it in the physicality part of the fight, in the trenches, in the clinches, when the guy's pushing you around and muscling you, when you want to get away, when you've been hurt and you want to get away and you can't get away because he's just too big. You can't even clinch with him. So there's a lot of factors here that can count against Lopez, but I think he's got to get respect early. He's got to do the same thing that's got him here. He's got to fight.
Guys, great stuff. We're getting you ready for the main event. We're just about set right now for Canelo Alvarez. But first, before we do, an important moment here inside this arena. A man who is supposed to be here in the ring, but he is in here indeed. Let's go down to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, the time has come for the bout you've all been waiting for. It's time for Canelo versus Lopez.
Canelo Alvarez. He's vicious, unrelenting, the pride of Mexico. At 22, the undefeated WBC champion has had a meteoric rise. Tonight, with an entire nation behind him, his destiny seems preordained. But in boxing, everything can change in a single punch.
Oh, qué perro el morro. Pero que no gane.
Josesito Lopez wasn't supposed to be here.
Lopez stepping up. Oh, they stopped it.
Oh my God, broke him in.
Lopez pulls up the upset of the year.
He embodies the essence of boxing. In the ring, anything can happen. Tonight, will the superstar's ascent continue? Or will the underdog write another storybook ending? It's Canelo Alvarez versus Josesito Lopez. And nothing is preordained.
Well, they say every dog has his day. For Josesito Lopez, that day came back on June 23rd when, trailing on the judges' scorecards, he landed a lightning bolt that broke the heavily favored Victor Ortiz's jaw, forcing the vicious one to capitulate at the end of the ninth round, giving Lopez the biggest win of his career. And after the Paul Williams tragedy and James Kirkland being ruled out as an opponent for Canelo when financial terms couldn't be agreed upon, Lopez has earned the biggest payday of his career.
Hey, you know, I've been around Josesito a lot in the last several days doing features for Showtime. And all the while, I must have asked him four times in different features, is any of this getting to you? Is it a distraction? How are you able to deal with this? Every time he said, I'm here, I'm focused just on this fight. This is the moment that he has been waiting for. Will he be as focused as he needs to be with all his hoopla?
Yeah, this guy only knows how to do one thing. He only knows how to fight. He's here. He never gets the script. He doesn't knock on the door. He kicks in the door. This guy, every time he's knocked in his career, he's not been let in. He lost a close decision to Jesse Vargas. So what did he do in the Victor Ortiz fight? He broke his jaw and knocked him out. He will not knock tonight. He'll come to fight. He's coming to kick in yet another door and reach the entrance to superstardom.
Will lightning strike twice, or is the clock about to strike midnight on boxing's latest Cinderella Man?
And now, making his way to the ring, the challenger, Josesito.
The crowd is rough, but this is the moment Lopez has been waiting for his entire life, his entire career. This crowd is going to be tough on him, but this guy is just steel.
No surprise at the reaction that Lopez is receiving, but I'm sure that he is going to be able to try to channel this in a positive way for himself. He really has nothing to lose here tonight.
The trick here is he cannot let it channel him into being too reckless in this fight early in the fight. And that's something he's got to guard against.
Yeah, that's going to be on him. One thing I will say, though, at the Victor Ortiz fight, the crowd was against him as well. When he came out, that was a pro-Victor Ortiz crowd. But by the end of the night, those same fans were giving him a round of applause and cheering him on. So you never know. You know, Mexican fans are knowledgeable. Lopez is a Mexican-American, so he does have the Mexican blood. He may turn the crowd if he has things go his way.
The one thing that stuck out in the fighter meeting, what he told me and told us, he wants to earn Canelo's respect early.
His trainer, Henry Ramirez, made a point of that. They have to do that early in the fight or Canelo will steamroll him.
Yeah, you're right. You guys are right, and I think Lopez is right. He needs to give Canelo something to think about. Canelo can't just feel comfortable in there the whole time, because if not, that confidence will snowball.
He says he's at his physical and mental prime. He has worked on his defense. He felt he was getting tagged too much by Ortiz's jab. We're about to meet his opponent here tonight. It is fitting that on this Mexican Independence Day weekend, one of Mexico's brightest boxing stars is center stage here on Showtime. Despite only being 22, Canelo Alvarez is already a 7-year pro who is entering the ring for the 42nd time as a professional in his first feature attraction in the fight capital of the world, Las Vegas, and he is being treated to a volcanic eruption.
And we should point out that while it might be more, certainly than Josesito Lopez has seen before, even for Canelo Alvarez, this is a bigger kind of event in the United States than he has ever been a part of. But he's got a lot of experience at dealing with this kind of adoration.
Yeah, this is a big event, even for Canelo, as he's climbing the ladder to superstardom. I mean, he's basically there, but the sky's the limit for this guy as long as he does his job. You know, Mauro made a good point. 22 years old, but he's a veteran. He's been a pro for 7 years. One other thing, he's 22 years old and he's a world champion. A lot is expected of this guy.
And now, here he is, the defending world champion, Saúl Canelo Alvarez.
Deafening at the MGM Grand Garden Arena, Las Vegas. Listen to this crowd.
A lot of energy, guys.
As a child, he was bullied and ridiculed for his unique features. Now, as a professional boxer, Canelo, which is Spanish for cinnamon, has turned his unique features into a very marketable commodity. It doesn't hurt that he's a pretty good fighter.
Now, that helps a little bit. and he is drinking in the adulation of this crowd, and this is a big moment for this young man.
Here is the tale of the tape for tonight's main event.
The most salient number as we look at our tale of the tape really is the weight of Josesito Lopez. He said to us he wanted to get as close to the 154-pound limit as he could, even though only two fights ago he was fighting at 140. He got up to 153. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? Will he retain his quickness at that weight? We'll see. And of course, there's the weight at fight time, a lot bigger for Canelo.
We are set for tonight's main event for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship. Here with the official introductions, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the MGM Grand Garden Arena here at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Nevada, for the featured bout of the evening. Y a todos nuestros amigos latinos, bienvenidos aficionados al box y feliz día de la independencia de México. Esta es la pelea estelar de la noche. Our main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, is brought to you by Golden Boy Promotions and Canelo Promotions, in association with Goose and Tudor Promotions, Thompson Boxing Promotions, and Showtime. We are sponsored by Corona Extra, La Cerveza Más Fina, DeWalt Power Tools, and their new 20-volt Max Brushless technology. They are guaranteed tough. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. This bout is sanctioned by the WBC. President Jose Suleiman, Supervisor Bob Logis, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman Skip Avancino, Executive Director is Keith Kaiser. Introducing to you our three judges scoring the bout from ringside. From Reno, Nevada, Bert Clements. From Braintree, Massachusetts, Dick Flaherty. And from Las Vegas, Nevada, Glenn Trowbridge. And our third man of the ring, the referee in charge, working in this, his final bout as a referee, fair but firm, Joe Cortez. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance, and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, it's Showtime! Introducing to you first, the challenger on my right, right here in the red corner, wearing white trunks with multinational, multicolored trim, hailing from and representing Riverside, California. He weighed in at already 153 pounds with a record of 30 wins, 4 losses, 1 no decision. He has 18 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the former youth and NABF champion, currently the WBC number 4 ranked contender, introducing Josesito. Opponent across the ring, the defending world champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the colors of Mexico, red trunks with red and green trim, hailing from and representing Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. He weighed in at the super welterweight limit of 154 pounds, with a record of 40 wins, no losses, 1 draw. He has 29 wins coming by way of knockout. And tonight, making the fifth defense of his title, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome one of the dynamic young stars of boxing today, the undefeated WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, aquí está el gran ídolo mexicano, Saúl Canelo Alvarez. Once again, the referee in charge now to give instructions, Joe Cortez.
All right, gentlemen, I gave you the rules in the dressing room. Debe la regla de todo el camerino. Espero una pelea limpia. Espero a good, clean fight. Protege en todo momento. Remember, guys, I'm fair, but I'm firm. Mucha suerte, que Dios lo bendiga a los dos.
For the main event of the evening, the champion, the 22-year-old Canelo Alvarez versus Josesito Lopez, looking for a second consecutive major upset. He wasn't supposed to be here. The paths were not supposed to cross, but they're about to collide at the MGM Grand. It's the WBC Super Welterweight Championship, round one. The champion, Canelo Alvarez, in the red, green, and white. The champion, the challenger, Lopez, in the white with Mexican and American flags. And you talk about different atmospheres in the locker room. In the champion's atmosphere, much like the crowd here at the MGM Grand, a convivial one. Lots of singing, a lot of visitors in and out all night. Meanwhile, in Lopez's dressing room, it was quiet, all business. Very focused, very tense.
That's for sure. I should point out, good right hand by Canelo. They're going at it here in round one. I misspoke about the weight. I meant to say that Canelo, despite the fact that Lopez amazingly is a pound more, that he looks bigger than Lopez. But it's a story that Lopez actually is about at the same weight as Alvarez when this fight starts.
Opening minute of this championship bout, Lopez said he would bring the fight to Canelo. Canelo used to getting off to a very methodical, very measured pace. Lopez wants to get him out of his rhythm early, Paulie.
He does, but it seems like he's trying to measure the strength Canelo has. He's kind of sitting on the back foot, working off the jab. There he goes.
And a good combination. Hooks to the body by the challenger.
Fighting at a measured pace is Lopez, a lot more measured than he did against Victor Ortiz.
Stiff jab by the champion. Overhand right by Canelo.
A little movement from Lopez, not a lot, and a little is what, at least what he needs early in this fight.
It seems like Lopez is trying to feel out what kind of strength Canelo has. It is a new weight for him. I think he's trying to see exactly how things are going to open up here in the first round.
Remember, Lopez moved up from 140 to 147 to vanquish Victor Ortiz when Ortiz suffered a broken jaw and capitulated at the end of round nine, and now he's tasting the power of the champion here at 154. Lopez putting together some cool combinations.
Yeah, Canelo, nice shots to the body there. Lopez answering back, he's trying.
Alvarez is a combination puncher. Canelo can throw combinations, and we're seeing it early in this fight. It's maybe a misnomer some people think about him.
Canelo's lands a jab and the left hand just misses.
Canelo's actually throwing more power in the first round than we're accustomed to seeing him.
Yep.
We thought it might have been Lopez to try to start fast, but it seems Canelo wants to impose his size and strength early.
Canelo and his camp have said it time and again. They are set to take on the next level and wanting to make a statement here on Mexican Independence Day weekend, headlining his first major fight in the fight capital of the world, Las Vegas, and off to a good start here with 10 seconds remaining in the opening round. Canelo Alvarez, Josesito Lopez for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship.
For Canelo Alvarez, he wants to create some doubt early. He may have done that with some monstrous left hooks, and the 1-2 will work. I think the jab and a straight right hand, which he also threw, is good. And guess what? He threw that hook to the body a lot. So far, in my mind, he's on pace in those keys to victory.
Now, for Lopez, he can't remain stationary during the course of this fight. He has moved a bit. He's tried the double left hook early. It didn't quite work. Got to use his hand speed. He has not done that with combination punching yet.
I'll tell you, it looks like Canelo read your keys to victory before he got in the ring.
Apparently.
It seemed to me Lopez in that first round had trouble finding his distance a little bit. He was trying to, the times he did try to get off combinations, he either landed them, they got blocked, or Canelo actually stepped back and Lopez found himself kind of having to stop the combination midway through. So let's see, he was a little tight. It might have been the crowd noise, it might have been this new atmosphere. Let's see how he relaxes here in round two.
Round two underway. Canelo Alvarez paying tribute to the legendary boxing and boxers who have been coming out of Mexico over the years with the throwback trunks and really very excited to be fighting on this Mexican Independence Day weekend. Although Lopez now bringing the fight to the champion, has Canelo on the ropes, and he told us in the fighter meeting that somewhere he wanted to keep the champion.
Nice hook right hand. Good left hook right hand by Lopez there. Alvarez clapping his hands, telling him to bring it.
Now, you notice Lopez stepped away after that exchange. He doesn't want to just stand there and exchange with Canelo.
And Canelo Alvarez now a couple of left hooks to the body and now putting together the combination. Tagging Josesito Lopez. Great action here in round two. Oh, and a right uppercut finds the target.
Lopez said, what will Canelo do if he's faced with adversity? In that mini moment, Canelo answered the call. He came back after getting whacked against the ropes.
Yeah, he actually looked like he got angry and threw some heavy, heavy shots.
Great combination. The left hand to the body and the left hook upstairs by the champion Canelo Alvarez.
Action is opening up here in round two.
Another flurry of punches from the champion. The jab on the proboscis.
Lopez is staying off the ropes, not letting himself get trapped. Nice hook by Lopez.
And
he's
Lopez
got a good one.
Showcasing composure here, not getting lost, not getting caught up in the moment. His trainer, Henry Ramirez, feeling that he's as strong, as fast as he's ever been, despite moving up what is essentially two weight classes. Gets tagged with the right hand, comes back with the right, but misses with the left. A minute left here in the second round, and Lopez, again, missing with that right hand as Canelo Alvarez has been able to avoid it. And has Lopez on the ropes, left hook to the liver.
Lopez likes to counterpunch off the ropes. That's not a good strategy against Canelo, but he said, I'm going to try it a couple times and see how I do. He's doing it right now.
Well, here, this is Canelo imposing his size here, guys. He's cutting off the ring. He's trying to trap Lopez on the ropes and use his physicality.
30 seconds left in the second round.
These are good competitive rounds so far in this fight.
So he's walking him down again. He's trying to impose that size and create that doubt inside Lopez's head.
Canelo able to land a couple of jabs. Another jab.
This knockdown in a round in which it was very, very close. They landed exactly the same number of punches, but the difference, this powerful left hook to the body. And remember, we said Lopez should not back himself against the ropes. He knew he shouldn't. Henry Ramirez knew he shouldn't, but he did, and he paid for it.
I love how Canelo set up that hook to the body. It's a throwaway punch. That second punch was kind of a throwaway soft right uppercut. He kind of just touched him with it. He didn't throw it hard, and then he just to get the momentum to his left side of his body so he could put some torque on that hook to the body. Great setup punch and a great hook to the body.
For the second time in his career, Lopez was on the canvas and just beating the count imposed by referee Joe Cortez. Round three underway. How will Lopez respond to
his first taste of adversity in tonight's main event.
They said they sparred with 160 and 170 pounders so he could feel the power, but the power of Alvarez right now with regulation size gloves made a difference.
And that's the thing, Al, it's the fight gloves. When you wear fight gloves, the regulation gloves, it's a lot different than sparring. Those things hurt.
Yep.
Alvarez again working behind his jab. Goes to the body and then the right uppercut. Canelo beginning to score it well, but Lopez showing his fight. And now another body shot.
He's too small.
Lopez down. 3 seconds left in the third round. Lopez has been down twice in the fight.
Lopez just landed an excellent right hand. It did nothing to Canelo.
The talk amongst boxing pundits and fans alike. The size of Canelo Alvarez. Would it prove to be too much so far? The power has proved to be too much for Lopez here as we in the third round again against the ropes. 33 seconds left. One-way traffic. And Lopez coming back with a body shot of his own.
And Canelo's body shots are hard. I don't know how Lopez is taking these. Man, is he game. And he's actually coming back with some good shots of his own at times.
No one can question the heart of Josesito Lopez.
Lopez has found a home for the straight right hand, but that's all.
10 seconds left in the third round. Right hand by Lopez. Another round in the books for the champion. Oscar De La Hoya, the golden boy, watching, well, boxing's new golden boy, Canelo Alvarez.
We look again at the second knockdown of this fight. Several looks from above. He gets great leverage on these body shots. A terrific left hook downstairs after he had landed the combination to the head. As Paulie talked about him setting up that body shot, he did it again. And Paulie, from every angle, it's just as painful.
Yeah, and you know what? I love the variation. Canelo touches up top, goes downstairs, and comes back up top. You know, Lopez is so game. He's not only getting up, he's getting up and fighting back. He's not looking for a way out of here. We'll see how much more he can take, or if he can get Canelo's respect here in the coming rounds. He's got to do something to get that respect because it's one-way traffic. But I tell you, Lopez isn't even looking at his corner for help or anything. I mean, he gets up and he fights.
Yes.
Round four underway. Many boxing experts thought that Canelo Alvarez would record a mid-round stoppage over the smaller but definitely very game Josesito Lopez, who went down from the left to the body with 10 seconds left in round two. Down again 55 seconds into round three from another left hook to the body.
Now, we've said by trade, Lopez is not really a boxer. Now, he's being forced into that now, moving, jabbing. Can he use this style effectively, even just to buy time? We'll see. Now, Canelo Alvarez, a stalker in this fight. Not as careful and methodical as he normally is.
A huge advantage in the power punching department for the champion. And what a percentage
When you land at 60-some percent, 62%, that's staggering in the show stats.
And that's a lot of credit has to do with
that. Oh, and he touches him again with the right hand. Sorry, Paulie.
Sharp counterpunches. Sharp counterpunches. You know, the high percentage of landing is also the variation. Lopez doesn't know where it's coming from. It's up top. It's to the bottom. It's from the left side. It's from the right side. Variation is the key to a lot of the offense Canelo's having success with.
Left uppercut grazes the chin. Lopez stays in the pocket, comes forward with a combination of his own. He's been battered, he's been bruised, he's been dropped twice, but he remains in the fight with a minute 20 left in the fourth round. Straight right hand from the champion. And again, he goes to the body, and again, Lopez is in trouble, doubled over, and he thinks that may have been a low blow. Insult to injury here.
You come in when you're ready.
Well, he's got 5 minutes. If I was him, I'd take my time because he probably has to recover from the rest of the offense that Canelo's dished out. So this is an opportunity for Lopez to kind of regain his composure and not only recover from the low blow, but also recover from some of the punishment he's taken. Let's see what he does here.
We will see it, and we can deduce whether it was, in fact, low. That one was. It was kind of on the belt line, but just low enough that it would be classified a low blow. If Canelo Alvarez, he didn't try and throw another punch there.
Yeah, good sportsmanship.
Yeah, it is good sportsmanship.
And Lopez taking only 45 seconds and jumping right back into the fray.
I'll tell you, I don't think I could respect Lopez more going into the fight, but I've got newfound respect for him. I mean, he's just tough.
He's a tough man, and even there, jumping back into the fray, maybe sooner than he should have.
When in doubt, he just punches. He just fights.
Lopez doubles up on the jab and goes downstairs to the body. And now it's Lopez opening up, but again, the champion absorbing all the shots and really not showing any effect from Lopez's offense.
And this mentally, what Canelo's doing here is trying to break Lopez down by walking him down right through his offense.
And there he back goes again shots. To the body and the right hand. Lopez is down for the third time in this fight.
That's tough. But Lopez had just thrown a lot of punches. He's probably trying to get his wind back. And while he's trying to recover his air, he got hit with a combination.
Round four is in the books. It's all Canelo Alvarez.
For the third straight round, Josesito, before the knockdown, this is the low blow that created issues for Josesito Lopez. He took about less than a minute to walk that off. Then Lopez had his moments in this round. Coming back, landing a right hand and some other shots. Didn't land them all cleanly, but you can see how aggressive he was here. However, Canelo came back, and with the body attack as a staple for the third straight round, would send Lopez down to the canvas.
And again, the variation caused that knockdown. You saw the jab, you saw a right uppercut, you saw hooks to the head, to the body. A lot of variation from Canelo.
Fifth round underway here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. WBC Super Welterweight Champion Canelo Alvarez in the red, green, and white trunks. The challenger, Josesito Lopez, moving up in weight. In the white with Mexican and American flags on his trunk.
Just when you think Lopez may be coming to the end of the night, he gets up, dusts himself off, and he looks focused again. He's coming out popping jabs this round. He's trying to do something.
But Canelo showcasing, as you mentioned, Paulie, a diverse attack, continuing to hone his skills. Let's not forget, despite this being his 42nd professional fight, he's just 22 years of age. And again, attacking the body, ripping away with the left hands. And Lopez comes back.
Lopez is getting caught on those ropes way too much, and that's what's helping create these opportunities for Canelo.
And Canelo again, three-punch combination.
You can tell Joe Cortez looking very carefully in there, but Lopez punching back well right now.
And yet,
Canelo was hands down, taking the shots and coming back with potent punches. Again, ripping away at the body as the champion. Lopez needs to circle away from the ropes.
I'll tell you what, Lopez defensively has made a slight adjustment. When he's on the ropes, he's moving his head a little bit more. Yeah. Before, he was just putting his hands up. As I say that, he stopped moving his head. He might be tired.
Joe Craig does look very carefully, but I'll tell you what. I don't know that he wants to stop this fight right now. Lopez is doing a good job. Lopez landing a lot of punches in this round. Not powerful, but landing them.
Yeah, yeah.
Final minute of the fifth round, and Lopez catches the champion with a right hook.
Oh, my. And three good right hands.
And a left uppercut. Lopez showcasing his second win here in the 47 seconds left in the fifth.
He's a live dog, guys. We compared him to Rocky. I mean, this is Rocky-esque. Fighting a bigger man and still not willing to give in but trade.
And yet, Alvarez again going downstairs with the left hands to the body. Tattooing Lopez along the ropes. 30 seconds left in the round.
That last sequence took something out of Lopez.
And now a couple of uppercuts with Lopez again along the ropes. Alvarez. Left uppercut misses, right hand connects. 10 seconds left in the round. And referee Joe Cortez intervenes. He's seen enough. Canelo Alvarez retains the WBC Super Welterweight Championship. A game, but overmatched Josesito Lopez. Vegas, knowing he was a huge underdog, and for Canelo Alvarez, doing what he needed to do, he closed the show in impressive fashion. And Paul the Punisher Williams, a great guest on hand here, a guest of Canelo Alvarez. In fact, he was supposed to be Canelo's opponent tonight before fate intervened and a tragic accident left him paralyzed below the waist. And Victor Ortiz, thumbs up, he was also supposed to be Canelo's opponent before running into Josesito Lopez, but he's showing his thoughts on this fight. Thumbs up.
An excellent performance by Alvarez, by Canelo Alvarez. And I don't want to rain on his parade, but that last round demonstrated some of his defensive liabilities. And those two men at ringside, obviously in Paul Williams' case, tragically not able to fight, but even Victor Ortiz thinking to himself, what if that was my left hands that were landing? Would it have been better? I'm a 147-pounder. But still, this young man is a fan-friendly fighter who has tremendous offensive skills.
And I think that's one of the reasons why he's fan-friendly, right?
Yeah,
it's the fact that there are those defensive flaws, too.
Part of the allure to making an exciting fighter is that he's hittable. I mean, Canelo has an incredible offense, great variation, and tremendous amount of power. But the fact that he's hittable makes him that much more exciting.
When you're a slightly vulnerable champion, you are gold. And you can use offense like he does.
And a lot of times,
a
lot of times fans appreciate you more.
This is where Josesito Lopez first got in trouble in this round. Now, Lopez landing a nice right hand as he had been, but that body work by Canelo Alvarez was just devastating in this fight.
He liked to use that uppercut to set up that body shot. It's the same thing he did in round one.
And here's where the stoppage happened. Joe Cortez looking carefully in it. There's no question Lopez was taking some punishment here. And Joe Cortez says that's enough. And Lopez not really too much of a protest. Another look at it. Alvarez landing that pulverizing right hand and ripping hooks. That one missed, but clearly he had Lopez against the ropes and in some trouble. Remember, Lopez had been down three straight rounds, so
good stoppage.
Yeah, there's context to this. Although Lopez had very good moments in this round,
he did. He was fighting the whole time, but ultimately Lopez is just so brave. He's not going to fold, so somebody has to rescue him from that.
And his power just wasn't enough to hurt Canelo. And as he wails away with that straight right. The concern by Joe Cortez was how he got tangled up here and might have been in a vulnerable position where he wouldn't be able to avoid a punch.
get up to Jimmy Lennon Jr. for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2 minutes 55 seconds in round number 5. A referee in charge, Joe Cortez, stops the contest. He is the winner by way of technical knockout. He is still undefeated and still the WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, El Gran Ídolo Mexicano, Saúl Canelo Alvarez.
This Mexican Independence Day weekend, it is indeed Viva Mexico as Canelo Alvarez closes the show, stopping Josesito Lopez in the fifth round, remaining undefeated and defending the WBC Super Welterweight Championship. And the experts, well, they got it right. They thought it would be a mid-round stoppage, and it ends in the fifth. Let's go now to Jim Gray, who is going to be interviewing the winner.
All right, Mo, congratulations. Canelo, congratulations to you. What is your assessment of how you fought tonight? To all of us, it looked like total domination and your use of power.
Felicidades, Canelo. Hoy, ¿cómo se siente después de la pelea que usaste en el día de hoy? ¿Cómo peleaste hoy?
Hice mi trabajo. Josesito es un gran peleador con mucho corazón. Hice mi trabajo. Me gusta tomar en serio mi trabajo. Tengo toda esta gente respaldándome. Gracias por todo su apoyo y estoy listo para lo mejor.
He did his job today. He definitely had the backing of the fans today. And Josesito has a lot of heart.
A tremendous amount of heart. Have you ever hit a guy as hard as you hit Josesito 4 or 5 times with those body shots and still have this guy survive?
¿Tú le habías dado tan duro a alguien así en otras peleas?
No, la verdad que aguantó mucho. Es un peleador con mucho corazón. Se le respeta la manera de pelear. Y pues hicimos buen trabajo. Hicimos buen trabajo. Se notó aquí. Estoy muy contento, ¿no? Hay que seguir trabajando para seguir estando aquí, así que todavía falta mucho.
He's very happy, but he still needs to work, and he's never hit somebody that hard, but Josesito, again, has so much heart in this fight.
Canelo, it was your first fight in Las Vegas. What did you learn about yourself here this evening?
¿Qué aprendiste de ti en tu primera pelea aquí en Las Vegas?
No, la verdad que es una gran experiencia para mí. Estoy muy motivado, muy contento de ser la primera estelar aquí en este hotel tan importante, así que me siento muy contento. Esperen muchas peleas de estas, mucho mejor. Y hay Canelo para rato.
There's going to be Canelo for a while. He's very happy with what he showed today. And he's, again, happy that the fans came out to see him today.
Are you ready to move up to the next level and possibly face the Cloud Cotto winner or perhaps Floyd Mayweather?
¿Quieres subir a otro nivel y pelear gente como Floyd Mayweather?
Claro que sí. Me encantaría. Sería un honor para mí.
Of course, it would be an honor for me to fight and move up in the next level.
What do you have to improve on?
¿Qué tiene que mejorar?
Muchas cosas. Hay que seguir aprendiendo, mejorar mi golpeo. En el boxeo no se deja de aprender, así como en la vida, así que hay que seguir para adelante.
Boxing, like in life, you always learn. He has a lot of things to learn, but he'll be better the next time.
How much pressure are you feeling to live up to the expectations of all these fans to sell out this arena, not only in Mexico, but now in the United States?
¿Qué presión siente, no solamente en México, sino en Estados Unidos, que vienen todos de esta gente a verte?
No, es una gran responsabilidad para mí. Para mí esto es una motivación en vez de que sea una presión, es una motivación muy grande. Espero la gente siga apoyándome. Yo no les voy a fallar nunca.
It's really motivation that really drives him, and that's what he came to do.
You're learning English. Would you like to say something to this crowd in English?
Next time, and speak English.
Next time.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
We'll see you next time. Josesito, come on over. You're a very tough man, and you represented yourself very well tonight. Was it just simply a case of him having too much power?
Yeah. Canelo's chingón. Canelo's a badass. He's good. He's a good fighter. You know, I knew coming in it was going to be a tough fight. And he proved it. He proved it. He proved that he's a better fighter.
You moved up from 147, put on the extra pounds. Was that the difference in this fight, fighting just a much bigger, more powerful man?
Definitely, yeah. It's way out of my weight. You know, we felt good. We felt good, but I think the size was pretty different in there, and he's a strong fighter and a smart fighter.
Yet you went down 3 times and you got up every time, and Paulie and Al Bernstein were saying perhaps this is a rocky moment. In your mind, did you think for just a moment when you were fighting back that there could be a chance to escape and win this fight somehow, some way?
felt there all, there's always a chance. There's always a chance, and you know, I was hoping that I could, you know, land a good punch, because he was a smarter fighter, patient, stronger, you know, and I was just looking to catch that one punch where I could change the momentum.
You're a tough man. We enjoyed watching you fight. Hope you feel okay.
Thank you.
All right, Mo, back to you.
Oscar De La Hoya celebrating with Canelo Alvarez as he remains the WBC super welterweight champion, closing the show as referee. Joe Cortez has to intervene and stop the fight. And Josesito Lopez, refreshing to see such a candid fighter. He admitted to being in over his head.
Yeah, very honest about that.
And we did indeed, fellas, have knockouts tonight. Canelo Alvarez celebrates. He deserves it. And at the start of the night, we told you that you would have a chance to vote on the knockout of the night. And you would have a chance to actually make the call on who takes home an extra $100,000. So the time is now, right after the main event, for you to join the action and vote via text messaging to 74699 and choose the best knockout of the night. And let's refresh your memory. Here are the choices for tonight's Knockout King for who will win $100,000. First off, let's go in chronological order here. Leo Santa Cruz dominating the action, retaining his IBF bantamweight championship. Eric Morrell's corner would stop it after the sustained attack from Santa Cruz at the end of round five. So if you'd like to vote for Leo Santa Cruz, text Boxer 7. Again, Boxer 7 if you'd like to vote for Leo Santa Cruz. Again, 74699. Leo Santa Cruz started the show here on Showtime with a stoppage. Text Boxer 7. Now, in the WBA welterweight title eliminator, this was an exciting fight. You had Marcos Maidana boxing aggressively and effectively. Jesus Soto Caras would not be discouraged, but it would be Maidana who would stop Soto Caras in round 8. If you'd like to vote for Marcos Maidana, it was a very good fight, you can text Boxer 5. Again, 74699, text Boxer 5 if you'd like to give the $100,000 to Marcos Maidana. And in our main event, the WBC Super Welterweight Championship, you just saw it. You have 3 knockdowns, 2 from body shots. Al, I want to ask you about that. 1 from a double right hand. And then, of course, the stoppage. It's Saúl Canelo Alvarez taking apart a very game, and you're right, of course, guys. All of you had mentioned it. Then, Paul, you mentioned you didn't think you could have more respect for Josesito Lopez, but we do now. But he just got chopped down, and it was Canelo Alvarez knocking him down. The sustained, brutal, withering attack. Finally, Joe Cortez jumps in and stops it. Again, after 3 knockdowns and then the barrage. If you'd like to vote for Canelo Alvarez, text 74699 and text Boxer 1. All right, fellas. Again, you have 5 minutes. You have 5 minutes to vote here. And again, $100,000 check. I guess, Al, it's one of those big checks, right? You don't give
a
little check.
Giant check.
It's a big check for $100,000. You have 5 minutes to vote right now. Let's talk about the main event. And look, everything advertised, basically. Yeah. I mean, in a tremendous atmosphere, Canelo Alvarez comes out and does his job. Al, how often do you see a guy with multiple hooks, separate knockdowns on that type of shot after at the end of combinations?
Yeah, here's the point about Canelo Alvarez. To paraphrase Randy Jackson, he's got mad offensive skills, and we know this. And you pointed out, Paulie, it's a very diversified attack, and Josesito Lopez kept using the word intelligent. He is a terrific offensive fighter. He's a terrific offensive fighter who you can hit. Josesito Lopez came back after the last knockdown and was hurting or hitting Alvarez. So that makes him a compelling figure in the sport of boxing. But make no mistake, on offense, he is hell on wheels.
From being at the ring apron then, Paulie, give us your whole thought about what you saw tonight.
I love the variation. I mean, Canelo's offensive variation is incredible. He throws punches from a lot of different sides, the right side, the left side, but they're up top, they're from the bottom, they're uppercuts, they're hooks. I notice he likes to set up that left hook to the body with a little touch right uppercut. He doesn't throw it too hard. He just throws it enough where his body torques and gains a lot of momentum to throw a hard hook to the body. And what that does is it makes the guy close his arms up. Once his arms are closed up, the body shot is open. And he does it a lot, and he dropped Lopez several times with that same combination. Be it at the end of a combination or be led with it. It was always, a lot of times, do a few punches, touch right uppercut, and a hook to the body.
Yep. Admiral, look, it's different even sitting up here or when they're watching it on TV. But when you're there at the ring apron, what is it like to hear and feel those thudding shots from Canelo Alvarez?
Well, Canelo Alvarez has a lot of power in his punches, and there's no doubt about it. He is very dynamic when it comes to his offense. And we look at the highlights from this main event. You can see, and we wish you could hear for yourself what Canelo Alvarez is able to do on offense.
It is a varied attack. And these will be the three knockdowns that we'll see. That's the first one. And that uppercut that Paulie alluded to, which helped set up the left hook to the body. And a smaller man not able to absorb these kind of body punches. That's not to suggest that Canelo doesn't hurt 154-pounders with his left hand. But, again, it's the repeating theme you talked about, Paulie, with the uppercut and the left to the body.
We're talking about three knockdowns here. The first two come at the end of combinations where Canelo Alvarez goes to the body, and then he comes up with a third knockdown on double right hand. So you talk about, right, a diverse attack you guys were talking about. And at one point, Paulie, you yelled out, he doesn't know any other way to fight. But, man, he kept coming back until the bitter end.
Yeah, exactly, man. I mean, Joe Cortez has to rescue him because he's just going to keep on fighting. He's actually too brave for his own good. Here he would get almost backed up into a corner. He'd get knocked down. He'd take a beating. And then suddenly he dusts himself off and come back.
And I want to make a point about, as Joe Cortez comes in and stops this fight, I want to make a point about Josesito Lopez. What he demonstrated tonight is that he's a skillful fighter, which we saw in the Ortiz fight. This is a fighter who should get an opportunity at 147 pounds. They should give him a chance to go back down to 147 and fight a meaningful fight. He deserves that. He took one for the team. He went up and fought a 154-pounder, and he fought him as well as he could.
All right, 22 years old. You see the level of progression. You see the effect that he can have in the ring, and a tremendous attack, and it's spectacular in so many ways. Let's talk about the future, and we're talking about just big names, and he wanted just big names even for this night as well. He wanted Paul Williams. He wanted Victor Ortiz.
James Kirkland was in the mix.
James Kirkland briefly was involved. Al, how does he stack up against the highest level?
The 154-pound division has all kinds of good fighters. The ones he wants are two people. Let's face it. He's looking at Floyd Mayweather Jr. or Miguel Cotto. And Miguel Cotto is going to be fighting Austin Trout in December. Those are the men he would like to take a step forward and fight. And offensively, he's right there to do it. The question is defensively, or does he have such a good chin that it doesn't matter? They're not going to hurt him. We're going to find that out.
You know, one thing about Cotto, he actually won rounds from Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah.
And Paulie, that's very rare. But, I mean, Mayweather is still another animal completely, right? I mean,
Mayweather is very skilled. Mayweather is very skilled. But Cotto would be a tremendous fight. I mean, these are two hard body punchers. They both like to be in the trenches. I mean, Canelo likes to be in there. Cotto likes to be in there. I think it would be a fight of the year candidate if those two guys get it on.
Let's remind you once again. Again, we have a few moments here. We're going to let you text, let you vote. And again, the winner of the vote, your vote, will get an extra $100,000. We're not talking small change here. Let's go back to the start of the night and refresh your memory. I don't want to say the last thing you saw. Of course, you're going to be influenced by it, but you go back to Leo Santa Cruz. Again, going up against a very game Eric Morrell. Paulie, you mentioned, hey, Morrell might not have the legs later in the fight, the way he was getting chopped up. And sure enough, there just wasn't anything left. I think his corner did a good job. You guys had mentioned it. If you'd like to give it to Leo Santa Cruz, text Boxer 7, 74699, text Boxer 7 for Leo Santa Cruz. And again, moving up, Marcos Maidana. I'll just paraphrase what you guys had said for those just joining us. Maidana with a very different attack, and he was skillful, he was aggressive, but Jesus Soto Carlos kept answering back. It was frisky, right? They went out after each other after the bell a few times. But in round 8, it would end. So Marcos Maidana also involved in this. And if you'd like to vote for him, and what was an outstanding fight, 74699, text Boxer 5. And one final time in the main event, it was Saúl Canelo Alvarez with three knockdowns. Again, going to the body. It was a beautiful thing to watch if you're a purist. You had a double right hands that knocked him down as well. Joe Cortez was hovering throughout the round. So he was looking for something there to tell him, I need to save this guy, and he finally did. If you would like to give the check and the bonus, the $100,000 bonus to Canelo Alvarez, text Boxer 174699. Not like he's going to need the cash, but I'm just saying, fair is fair.
I think 100 grand is what he has between his couch pillows and underneath the car seat.
Yeah, the irony of this is he's the one guy that might not need that 100 grand, but still, fair, as you point out.
All right, so what are we thinking? Is there any, I'm thinking, well, it seems fairly obvious, unless you think otherwise. Paulie, who do you vote for?
You know, it's tough. Canelo had a dominant knockout, but I think Maidana had the more durable guy. And I prefer the Maidana knockout because, you know, besides the fact that he got a great stoppage, it was also against a guy who's bigger. It was against a guy who'd only been down once in his career. He scored a knockdown in the fight, and then he physically beat him down and got the stoppage. Tough to go against that Canelo KO. I mean, he physically destroyed Lopez.
But like you said, Paulie, I think everyone expected, because of the size difference and everything, for Canelo to close the show. And I echo his sentiments. I like the Maidana stoppage.
Strength of schedule he's going by.
Exactly. Well, boxing's like college football. It's the only place where you can't tell a champion all the time on what happens in the field. I got to be honest, I'm going to go with these guys. I agree with every point that's been made. And this is not to denigrate what Canelo did, but that was remarkable. Maidana, remember, behind in that fight, and or at least in trouble at some point in the fight, not behind. And so he had to come back from a lot of difficulty.
Okay, I like
now
you.
You're going to go against
normally
us.
I'm the devil's advocate, and I would take your spot. You've all lost your minds because, come on, what did you just watch? I'd have to say it seems obvious it was an electrifying performance, yes, against a guy who was at least one weight class
down. Are you going to bring us back down to earth? Is that what
you're saying? You already presented the opposite side of things, and I understand you can vote, and you can again text
here.
Your favorite. Yeah. It's a good debate. I'm glad you brought it up. Yeah, degree of difficulty, the scheduling, it's very different. Yeah. The man that was in front of him, and yet we'll see what the voting says again. Canelo
and you're right,
Alvarez.
Not to take away from Canelo. Because when you expect someone to do something, he still has to do it, and he did.
Yeah, and three times, and then not even knocked him up the fourth time, but then he got the stoppage, so it's pretty electrifying. I don't want to sway the voting, I'm sure.
Well, I always get mad at the judges on the reality show when they actually do make a prediction, say, don't sway the audience, so here we are.
Here we are. All right, again, you do have a choice. There is the man himself. And look, basically, in terms of in the ring, great progression. In terms of marketing, also a great progression, fellas. And like, oh, the choices are there now for Canelo Alvarez.
It's because of the way he performs. You know, that wasn't just he landed, was facing a man that was coming up in weight, landed one big punch, and Aldani went. No, it was the body of the work in that fight.
And in a perfect world, you would maybe want to wait a little while. The fact that he's 22 years of age, you would want to maybe continue to move him along. But he's an attraction. He's a bona fide box office attraction, and that's what boxing needs.
It comes down also to who do you want to pay to see. And then, of course, tonight the choice is who do you want to actually pay. And the votes are in, and he will be $100,000 richer. Look, you guys made a spirited defense, but you could not overwhelm what was done as far as the fans out there. You voted out there, and they voted here in the arena as well. I think we know what will happen here. Let's go inside the ring once again to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the ring, we have Oscar De La Hoya ready to present the $100,000 bonus for the knockout of the night, as determined by you, the fans. Congratulations to Canelo Alvarez.
I have one more announcement to make to all the fighters that participated. Since you guys fought your heart off, we're going to give you an extra $25,000 each. To Leo, to Ponce, to Maidana, congratulations. A todos los que también participaron, a Maidana, Ponce y a Leo, porque pelearon con mucho corazón, les vamos a dar $25,000 a cada uno también. Vamos. Y que viva México.
Bravo, campeón. Bravo. Look, this crowd knows quality when they see it. Oscar De La Hoya knows quality when he sees it as well. This was a tremendous card. Top to bottom, Al.
Yeah, it was a tremendous card. We thought it was going to be. That's exactly what it was. And Canelo Alvarez looked to the future with his performance and made it look like a bright future.
Paulie, your thoughts?
You know, I thought it was great top to bottom. Maidana rebounds with a great win. You got Leo Santa Cruz, who's a young star up and coming. Canelo, a young star, bona fide superstar already. You know, and Ponce de Leon gets his career back on track with a great win over Johnny Gonzalez.
Mauro, I mean, when we're talking, hey, the possibilities are Miguel Cotto, Floyd Mayweather. We're talking, you know, the height of the sport right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, Canelo Alvarez's future, very, very bright. But as the rest of the panel said, just a tremendous night of fights. And on this Mexican Independence Day weekend, all I can say is Viva Mexico, Knockout Kings delivered.
It absolutely did. Again, start to finish, including the main event. Recapping tonight's fights here in Las Vegas, again, to a packed house at the MGM Grand Garden Arena. It started off with Leo Santa Cruz retaining his IBF bantamweight title. Again, tremendous work rate, a well-rounded attack, a sustained assault on the former flyweight champion, Eric Morrell, who had quite a reign as well as a champion, winning by TKO at the end of round five as Morrell's corner called it. And Santa Cruz stays undefeated. Marcos Maidana going at it with Jesus Soto Carras. They waged a welterweight war. Maidana scoring the only knockdown from straight right in round seven. A barrage of shots causing referee Kenny Bayless to stop this one in round eight. Maidana moves to 32-3, and again, his reputation enhanced as an all-action fighter. It was a great and also improvement, as you guys pointed out, in his style with a new trainer. And then the semifinal, Johnny Gonzalez and Daniel Ponce de Leon. And Ponce de Leon scoring the only knockdown of the fight when he sent Johnny Gonzalez through the ropes at the end of round six, and a good call that it was a knockdown. An accidental clash of heads caused it to go to the scorecards. De Leon winning by technical decision. He was ahead on all three judges' cards. He's now 44-4. And then in the main event, Canelo Alvarez closing the show with style. Josesito Lopez attacked early. He drove Canelo to the ropes, but Canelo stormed back. And then after, you're talking about three different knockouts, separate knockdowns. Paulie Malignaggi saying, look, Josesito Lopez doesn't know any other way to fight. He went out on his shield. Joe Cortez hovering all through round five to call a stop to it, does indeed do so in round five. And Canelo Alvarez, at the age of 22, is now unbeaten in 42 professional fights, and the future is indeed bright for the young fighter from Mexico. Well, in case you missed any part of tonight's action or you just want to watch the fights for a second time, I in fact do. You can check out our replays on Showtime and Showtime Extreme. Coming up next Friday, September 21st, it'll be episode 2 of All Access, Canelo versus Alvarez. We will chronicle the post-fight with exclusive coverage of the celebrations and the reactions from both fighters and their camps. Saturday, September 29th, Strikeforce is back in the cage. Gilbert Melendez defending his lightweight title against Pat Healy. And then we get back to championship boxing Saturday, October 20th, with a rematch of Danny Garcia against Eric Morales from the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. We will see Paulie Malignaggi there as well, this time without the sharp suit, although you looked very good tonight, my man. Thank you, fellas. For Mauro Ranallo, Al Bernstein, Paulie Malignaggi, Jim Gray, Steve Farhood, and our entire crew, I'm Brian Kenny. Thanks for watching, everybody. Good night from Las Vegas.